My love.
No, I'm okay. Listen, about that trip to Canada, I don't think I can make it. Something important just came up. I'm sorry, Lisa.
Are you kidding me?
But you can still go though. Take some friend with you and afford the beer.
Seriously? What is so important than going out together? I have been waiting
for... My wife just finally got pregnant. And I need to be there to support her. You know how hard we've been trying.
What is this? You cancelling the trip just because your wife is pregnant?
If you still want to go on this trip, let me know by tomorrow. You've just made me the happiest man in the world. Now I get to be called a father. I love you.
I love you too. Could you give me some water, please? I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
Are you sure? It is is water that you want? You killed my son. And I don't want to see you anywhere near me again. I want you to get out of my house.
It was an accident. I should have been more careful.
Enough. Pack your things and get out of my house. You're welcome. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Thank you.
Yes. You're tired.
Okay. Yes. Two shots of brandy. Okay. On the rocks.
No problem.
Thank you.
That'll be on me.
Wow.
Oh, so you paid for that?
Yeah. Great.
I'm so sorry about your son. It was an accident. Do you know what you've done to me? My husband chased me out of my house because of you. I understand what you're going through. And I'm sorry.
Sorry?
You're sorry. Have you ever lost a child before? You don't know what I'm going through. I'm truly sorry. Thank you.
No.
Sometimes I wonder, but I'm
Atu! Atu!
Is everything all right?
Yep.
Something is wrong. You can talk to me.
I'm pregnant.
Is that why you're crying?
I'm surprised. Mom, I haven't missed my period. And they say that the baby's gonna come in a few months.
I'm here. It's going to be all right.
I'm not ready to have a baby, Mom. Not just yet.
It's going to be fine.
Thank you.
I can see you happy. Oh, and your face is glowing. Oh, thanks to me. I am sure someone is getting spoiled.
Oh, tell me about it. I can't even make my own cup of coffee. That foolish man
is in love.
That's the exact place we want him to be. You know, revenge is best served as a cold dish.
I'm not sure he didn't see that coming.
Stupid man. Let him continue being in the dreamland. But I really don't like the idea of you being pregnant. It was not part of the plan.
I know, right? I don't like it either. But don't worry about it. Our plan is still intact.
Oh my god.
Killing your own son? You are a disgrace to motherhood. Honey, let's go.
Dima, oh mother, wena. Dima, oh pinja, wena. Kungo tenga nsambilesa. Amaona, tendere suma ugura. Poliza, wena. Dima, oh mother, wena. Dima, oh pinja, wena. Kungo tenga nsambilesa. Amaona. Tendere suma wukula, poliza wena. Dima o mada wena. Dima o pinja wena. Kungo tenga nsambilesa. Amaona. Tendere suma wukula, poliza wena. Dima o mada wena.
You know, I don't like seeing you so sad. What are you doing now? Looking at those pictures again. Oh, please, give me the phone.
Give me your... I miss him so much, Mom.
I know, but remember, he's your guardian angel now. He's always, always watching over you.
I'm sorry. I lost the babe.
We did our best. How are you coping?
Things are not okay. He really wanted a child.
Why are you sounding as if you're falling in love?
Come on. We just lost a child.
So?
Really?
Don't lose focus now. Remember why you're here.
Do you need to remind me about that? Well, if it makes you feel better,
he's leaving for the US in the next 4 months. He's going there to do his master's degree for 18 months.
Perfect. You know what? By the time he leaves, you are pregnant.
What?
labor so impossible.
Duh.
Don't cry, baby. You're safe with me. You're very safe with me. What a beautiful baby girl. Welcome, my dear. We've been waiting for you. What shall we call her? Grace?
No, ma'am. Happiness.
Happiness? Yes. Happiness. She looks just like her grandmother.
Come on, ma'am.
Oh, yes. You look just like me. Don't you?
Research. I hate marketing.
You're joking, right? I mean, accounting is the most difficult. I wish I had taken another course.
Did anyone force you to study accounting?
You're right. Come in.
Wow. Well, this is what I like seeing. You girls are really working hard.
Yeah, we're trying our best, Dad.
You should.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Shikoji.
I'm so happy you guys are here. You know, I really missed you.
We missed you too. But you know what? You need to study hard.
I am.
Oh, yes.
I know.
Well, won't take long. We'll leave you two to study.
Yes.
Oh, okay. But, Dad, did you manage to transfer the money?
Of course I did.
Oh, thank you, Daddy.
You mean you didn't get the money?
Mommy, I didn't even check. Because, Mommy, I was so busy.
This girl is spoiled.
You can say that again.
We need to go.
Okay.
We'll see you soon. Come on, little honey.
Okay, girls, come in. Oh, it's a visiting day indeed. Hey, sis.
Hey.
Hi. How are you?
I'm good, thanks, and you?
I'm good.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
Oh, my God. You? So, Chikwandi is your sister?
Oh, you two know each other?
Of course. She used to be my secretary.
Yeah, a long time ago. I suppose this is your family?
Yes. This is my lovely wife.
Oh, yes.
And that's my beautiful daughter, Handy.
Nice meeting you.
It's a pleasure. Oh, but you know what? We're just leaving. So... we'll leave the room for you. Honey, we have to go.
Have fun, you guys.
Wait. Since your daughter is friends with my baby sis, we can as well be friends.
Sure, why not?
Let's catch up sometime.
No problem.
Handy? Alright, mommy.
Be good.
Okay.
Later.
Bye. I'll call you mom and dad.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
I won't be staying long. I also have to go. I brought you that you might like.
Wow. Thank you, sis. It's beautiful. I love it.
Thank you so much.
And I'll see you guys soon, hey?
Bye.
See? It's beautiful.
This bag is so beautiful.
I'm telling you, it's dope.
Friend, you're so lucky.
I'm telling you.
What's wrong, babe? What's eating you up? You're so distant these days.
I don't know what you're talking about. I mean, I can't be with you full time. I'm a student, remember?
I know, but... No, we rarely ever meet. It's been a week.
Okay. I get it.
How about I come to your house and spend the night?
Well, that would be nice. Okay. I really would love that.
Okay.
Hey. Andy, hi. Anyways, it's Chipotin. I'd like to see her.
Oh, please. Don't waste my time.
Andy, people make mistakes. Alright, and I'm not the first one. I'm not going to be the last one.
You cheated on my friend. Because she wasn't good enough for you.
And how is that your business?
She's my friend.
Hi, babe.
Girlfriend, I'm going out. But if I were you, I was going to dismiss him. What do you want?
I
don't want to say something that I'll regret. Let's go back to where you came from.
My love.
Excuse me.
We can even talk about this. Baby, please.
Remember I told you about my sister, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, the one in the village? She's home. So I really need to be there. Seriously, I have to go right now, right?
Andy.
Yeah?
Do you remember a friend of mine I told you about from the UK?
Happiness?
Yeah,
I do. What's up with her?
You know she's in town. She came back a few days ago. So I was thinking maybe you should go meet her up.
Nope. I have a business due this morning. But I'll see what I can do in the afternoon. Maybe I can just come hang out with you guys later.
Oh, okay. That's fine.
How long is she here for?
She's actually here to stay.
and she'll be studying here.
Who does that? Leaving UK for what? That's foolish.
Come on, her mother is sick, so she had to be closer to her.
Whatever.
All right, I'll see you later.
Okay, good.
I've been good. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm very fine.
How is Malawi? As beautiful as ever.
I can see. I mean, it's reading all over you.
You don't look bad yourself.
Really?
Yeah.
So, what are you having?
Oh, nothing. I'm good.
Are you sure?
Yeah, maybe later.
All right.
Yeah.
Right.
So, how is your mom now?
No, my mom is fine.
Okay.
You know mothers. She just wanted me around.
You know, right?
It's good to have you back.
Hey guys.
Hi.
Guys, meet Upgrade and Afraid. Meet Chico and Happiness.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice meeting you guys.
Afraid, yeah. Hey. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Danny has been asking about
Excuse
you.
Excuse me? Danny and I are not husband and wife. I'm a free bird, remember?
So, who's buying drinks?
What are you having?
I'm gonna have brandy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Babe, that was my boss.
Okay.
He wants to see me, so I'll call you later, right?
Okay.
Girls, I'm sorry, I have to run.
It's okay.
Babe.
Hi.
Babe? Don't go there.
Why are you doing this?
Because I'm so sick and tired of you nagging me like a child.
All I'm asking for is a little quality time with my girl. Is that too much to ask for?
I have to meet Mommy Tom. And it's getting late.
Okay, let me come with you.
Are you listening to yourself? What do you want my mother to think of me? It's either you wait or...
Okay. I'll wait. But just don't switch off your phone again, please.
Yes, we did. But if I remember correctly, I said no. This cannot stay here. And it was best.
You know, I'm trying to get well.
I'm not talking to you. Stay out of it. Chico, your friend is not welcome here.
Don't worry. It'll be all right.
mommy. I'm good, and how are you? Your school is fine. How is grandma? I miss you too. No, my friends are fine. We are getting along just fine. Yeah, I'll see you next weekend. All right, say hi to grandma. I know. I'll call you later. Okay, bye.
We should do this again.
Oh, yes, we should.
So, did you like it?
Mm-hmm.
It did, huh?
Yes, I did.
All right.
Yeah, did you enjoy it?
Oh, yes, I did. 100%.
This thing doesn't want to close. Okay. So how about I come back tomorrow?
How about if I give you a call about that?
What's wrong with me, Miss Lawyer? Especially the one you're dealing with.
You know, this one is very stubborn. Imagine, the woman has 5 kids with him, and now the kids are suffering just because of his stupidity. Is that fair?
Idiot. The fool should rot in hell. You know, that's why I don't like men. They're called dogs for a reason.
Come on, Hendy. Not all men are dogs. Abby, I know you do your best to fight for the poor woman.
Oh, yes. Justice must be served.
The food tastes real good, Mom. You know, I miss your delicious cooking.
And I miss cooking for you, sweetheart.
So, how is grandma?
She's fine. She says that she'll be coming back next week. And she also says that the maze is doing really great.
That's good.
But can you imagine? She was worried because of the delay of the rain.
Come on, Ma. Your mother worries so much.
Oh, yes, she does. By the way, how's school?
School is fine. You know, all I'm thinking about is my forthcoming exams.
Don't worry, sweetheart. You'll do just fine. And I'm so sure you're going to pass with flying colors. Here, have some more sausage.
No, Mom.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm okay. This is enough.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know I'll not stop apologizing until you take me back.
I'm sorry.
Take you back? How many times do I take you back? Do you think I'm stupid so you can lie to me again?
No.
Hell no.
Baby, whatever I'm saying here, I mean every word.
You're always cheating on me.
I'm sorry. You know I love you, right?
Love. I'm tired of being lied to.
Baby, please. It's been 3 years, you know. 3 whole years. Give me a chance.
I need some time.
That's what you said some days ago. Please, I'm begging you.
I said I need time.
I have to go.
Why have you been avoiding me?
What?
I haven't received my payment for the past 4 months. Look at you. Driving a beautiful car, looking all comfy and classy. What's going on?
Come on, Lisa. I've been giving you money for the past 8 years. You know what? It's enough.
No. You're getting it all twisted. I say it's enough. When it's enough, not you.
Really? I've been doing all the work in the house, not you. And besides, that man is too old. No more. No more, Lisa. No more.
Wow. Look at you. I can see that you have grown wings, but you seem to be missing the point here. You are in that house because of me, and I know the plans to the game.
Well, girlfriend, let's just say the rules have changed.
Excuse me. I think it's time to show you who's boss.
You're not supposed to touch my phone. I'm not your wife.
Some stupid boy sends you a message on your phone. And instead of apologizing, you're insulting me?
What if it's a wrong number? You should have gone through my phone in the first place. Grow up.
You know what? I'm out of here.
Happiness. You need to take it easy with Dan. That guy loves you so much.
What do you know about love?
Excuse me.
I'm not ready for another fight. Not today.
Mm-hmm.
Hi.
Hi.
Just looking at you from across the counter, and you're not even turning your head.
Really?
I think we should go try another place.
Why? Why is she leaving?
Let me go check on Hendy.
Oh, come on. What's wrong with your friend?
I don't know. So, I hear you're a lawyer. How is it going for you?
Well, it's true, I am a lawyer. It's all good. I hear you're a lawyer too.
Oh, yeah. And it's exciting, yeah. You know, being in court on an actual case.
Yes, awesome. Yeah. At least we've got something in common. We can celebrate that. Have some more drinks.
Okay.
Can I have one more ginger?
Doesn't know what she wants.
Tell me about it. One minute she's trying to sort out her issues, and the next minute she's creating more problems.
Hello, I'm here.
She's a grown woman, so.
Exactly.
Hello? I'm good, and how are you? Ah, okay. All right. I'll see you soon. Okay, bye.
Who was that?
Some guy I met last week. You know, he has a case that he wants me to handle, so I have to meet him. Yeah. You know, I won't be around for lunch. Do you need anything?
No, thanks.
Okay. See you guys later.
Bye.
This is what I've managed to get. You'll get the balance next week.
Thank you, sis.
By the way, a friend of mine is looking for a good lawyer. Do you know anyone in town?
Why is she looking for a lawyer? Is she in trouble?
She has issues with her husband, and the situation is getting bad. So I want to help her, at least with a good lawyer.
A friend of mine, her name is Happiness. She's very good.
Thank you, sis.
You're welcome. You know, this coming Saturday is Dan's birthday, and I was thinking of surprising him. You know, maybe that's going to make him loosen up a bit.
You never cease to amaze me. Oh, that poor boy. So what do you want to do?
I want you guys to help me out.
Why don't we throw him a party and invite some few friends?
But we don't have money.
Relax. My daddy will handle it. I already spoke to him. So,
yeah, let's get to work.
Okay. Thank you.
What do you mean to do?
I told you to get a life. Stop stalking me. It's over between us. What is wrong with you?
Maybe we can always...
Don't touch me. What's your problem? After all, my sister told me you're a lousy boyfriend, which I can clearly see. So, get the hell out of here. Maybe you think because you're a lawyer and I can come running to you. Please, get a life. Have a party to get back to.
That's my girlfriend.
How?
Like my girlfriend, she's throwing a party for her boyfriend, for her other boyfriend.
What? Can you understand that? Yeah, how could you say she's a girlfriend and then she's throwing a party for another guy?
It's unbelievable, right?
It is unbelievable.
And there's gonna be other girls as well, right here. Yeah?
You know.
So you're sending me to sleep at home when there's going to be other girls here. Come
my
on.
My goodness.
Come on.
I don't want to be part of it.
No, I like Jameson mixing with brandy.
Oh, you like it hard, huh?
Yeah, like French, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I know what it is.
You're a very strong man.
You know what it is, huh? Yeah.
Guys! Guys, he's here!
Deserve everything you've got.
Happy birthday, sweetheart.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Hendy. And thanks, guys. I mean, I didn't anticipate this, but thank you so much. What a surprise.
See, I made all this for you, baby.
Thank you.
We love you, man.
We love you. Okay, DJ, time for music.
You're sick.
You can go now. I don't want to see your face. Hi. So, why did you leave the party?
I want to go home, okay?
Go home? The party just started and it's awesome. Why would you not do that?
I'm bored.
Yeah, the next two of us. Board.
Hey guys!
Hey, it's the birthday boy!
Congratulations, man, and you have to have a blast!
Thank you! Thank you!
Nice.
It's right? It's great, it's awesome!
Yeah, it is!
Max, would you give me and Happy a moment? I just need to talk to her for a bit.
No, Max. If you want to say something, say it right here.
Come on, just 2 minutes.
You know what, guys? I think I just remembered I have something to do somewhere there, so just enjoy your time.
Come on. Yeah, congratulations.
Cheers.
And don't forget, have a good time,
thank
right?
You.
Today,
thank
today.
You. Yeah.
Right, so.
Have a blast.
Okay, great.
Look, if I've offended you in any way, I'm sorry. I'm truly sorry.
Don't you dare touch me. Go back to your girlfriend and your stupid party.
Oh, come on. You know how I feel about you, and I know how you feel about me too. How long are you going to be fighting something so
just
obvious?
Go, okay? I don't like you.
It's gonna be okay. Come, let me take you home.
We should go. Push me. You know what I'm capable of. Don't you dare.
Do you think I'm scared of you? Bring it on.
You challenge me? You challenge me!
I miss Dan so much, but he keeps ignoring my calls.
You studied it.
If you have nothing good to say, just say it.
You pushed him away, cheating on him with Alfred and with the attitude. Just keep trying.
And the worst part is, I might be pregnant.
For who?
I'm not saying I'm pregnant. I'm just thinking. Or maybe I must just go home and talk to my mom. I'm so confused.
Yeah, talking to your mom might help. How does that make you feel?
What?
That Hindi could be pregnant.
Why did that concern me?
Oh, don't play innocent with me. I know what you're doing.
asking you, what are you doing?
It's not what you said.
You whore. So you're the one causing my daughter to lose sleep at night? Listen to me. Whatever nonsense you have is done. Ends here. Do you understand me?
Yes, ma'am.
Don't. Don't you dare call me that. I am not your mother. And I don't want Hendy to find out about this. But if I ever hear about this nonsense again, God help you. Get out of here. Go!
Thank you for meeting me.
You're welcome. You sounded so urgent on the phone. Talk to me.
Before anything, I want you to treat me as a client and not as your friend, sister. I hope everything we discuss here should be private and confidential.
You don't have to worry. This is part of my job, so you can trust me.
I want you to do whatever it takes to get me justice. I'll pay you real well.
I can only help you if I know the whole story. What is your case? And I need to know everything.
29 years ago, I lost the love of my life. He was everything to me. He was a married man, and I was the mistress. Everything was perfect until his wife got pregnant. He dumped me immediately without any consideration. It was painful. I became very furious and I planned for revenge.
So, what's this about?
I want to introduce you to someone. Do you remember that rich man that used to treat me like a queen?
Oh, yeah. And I also remember very well that you taught me that he's out of the country. So, what about him?
I lied. He dumped me just because his wife got pregnant.
Wow. So how does this concern me? Why am I here?
I want you to seduce him. I want you to make him fall in love and milk him of his worth so we can share 50-50.
You're joking, right? How would this man fall in love with me when his wife has given him the child that he so much wanted?
I have a plan. Mm-hmm. I want to get rid of her. I want to kill her.
You're joking, right? I am not a murderer.
This is a lifetime opportunity. He's a very wealthy man. So if you don't want to do it, I'll get someone else.
Hey, oi. How do you do?
We created an accident, but unfortunately, the son died instead of the mother. The man left his wife for my friend, and they're married until now.
Go on.
We agreed that every month I should be getting 300,000 kwacha. But now, nothing. She has become very greedy and has grown wings. So I want her to pay for the murder.
Okay, so before I go any further,
I need names.
The man is Mr. Banda.
And my friend's name is Getu.
Hinda's parents. The woman who lost her son is Atu Jaula.
Excuse me for a minute. I'm sorry about that.
That's okay.
I have to take you back a bit. May you please remind me again the agreement between you and your friend?
That she kills the wife and marries the man. And she gives me 300,000 every month. But now, she's not honoring the agreement.
And the names again?
Mr. Banda, Getu, and Atu Jaula.
Yeah, I think this is enough. I'll call you as soon as possible.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
once told me my brother died in a car accident. Gertrude Banda. Was she the one driving the car that hit my brother? And now she's married to your ex-husband, Mr. Banda. Where are you getting all this? Lisa Sugar. Was she your husband's mistress at some point? Answer me, ma'am. Why do you have to go digging into the past? It's not important. These are the people that killed my brother, your son, and it's not important? Mom, I need to get all the information from you. Please. Yes, that is all true. I can't believe this. And you let the woman who murdered your son marry your husband? Why didn't you fight for your marriage? At least for your son's justice. He didn't give me a chance. And I'm sure he didn't know who he was marrying. And besides, I've moved on from all this. Where are you getting all this from? Lisa Sugar is the one who masterminded the whole plot.
What plot?
It was not an accident, ma'am. I have the evidence. Here. Play it.
So, you're taking the guess, right?
Oh yeah, most definitely.
Why are people so wicked?
Let justice prevail. I'm going to make them pay for what they did to my brother.
Well, if you ever need any help, I'm always here for you.
What is this? Why are you kissing him?
He's my man, you know?
Definitely not anymore. Damn.
Get out.
I've said it compiling the case. You said there's more information I need to hear. So please, tell me about it.
Mr. Banda wanted a child. And Gertrude fell pregnant. But unfortunately, the child died. Gertrude was afraid to lose her husband. So, when Mr. Banda went out of the country, we made a plan. We decided to adopt a girl child. They called her Hendrina, your roommate.
So, Mr. Banda agreed to adopt?
No. Everything happened in his absence. He has no idea that Hendrina is not his biological child.
Okay. Anything else?
That's it.
All right, I think we have enough information. If anything comes up, I'll call you. Or if you have anything to share with me, don't hesitate to call me.
Great. Happiness. I hope you won't let me down.
I won't.
All right.
We're good to go.
So you've been summoned to appear before a court of law?
What is it all about?
It's nothing. Can we go, please?
Don't you think I deserve a better explanation?
I want to go home.
This is awkward, guys. I mean, it's been days. Please talk this out like sisters.
Sisters, you mean? Sisters don't sleep with sisters' boyfriends.
Happiness. I think you should end it with Dan. You know it's not fair to him.
What are you talking about?
Just stop it. You're nothing but a prostitute.
A prostitute. Life.
What came over your happiness? You have changed.
Excuse me. I have lots of work to do.
I wish I could stop the clock so this moment lasts forever. You look gorgeous tonight.
Thank you. Why are you stalking?
Will you shut up? What did I tell you last time? I told you not to mess with my daughter's boyfriend, didn't I? Cry, baby. One more word from you.
Excuse me?
In the first grade of Magistrate Court sitting at Lilongwe, criminal case number 204 of 1989, the state versus Gertrude Banda. Gertrude Banda is accused of murdering Sam Banda, contrary to section 209 of the Penal Code.
Your Lordship.
May you give me your verdict once again? Your name?
Gertrude Banda.
You are from?
Madzanje Village.
Jie.
Kwataini.
That is in jail.
Yes.
Miss Gertrude Banda, you are hereby accused of murdering Sam Banda, contrary to section 209 of the Penal Code. The allegations are that while you were driving on 21st July 1989, you unlawfully killed Sam Banda. Hence these charges against you. How do you plead?
Not guilty.
Not guilty. Right. May I have the prosecution? To plead the case.
Your Lordship, I would like to call to the stand my first witness.
Yeah, proceed.
I swear by the Almighty God that the evidence I shall give shall be the truth and nothing but the truth.
Please introduce yourself.
Lisa Sugar.
Miss Lisa Sugar, could you please explain to the court what happened in 1989?
It was a Thursday afternoon. Gertrude came by my house. By then she was already married to Mr. Banda. I was complimenting her about how happy she looks. And that's when she told me that if one has to be happy in life, one has to go an extra mile, whether it's good or bad. At first, I thought it was something simple, but I saw something in her eyes that made me so interested to know what exactly is going on with her life. That's when I kept on pushing. And that's when she told me she deliberately killed her husband's son and made it look like an accident.
Objection, my lord.
Overruled.
It was shocking 3 months later when Gertrude seduced her husband into marrying her. She took advantage of her husband's grief. It was all part of her plan. Mr. Banda does not know his wife deliberately killed his son.
Objection, my lord.
Objection overruled. Please proceed.
Could you please tell this court what happened before and after Mr. Banda went to Canada?
Before Mr. Banda went to Canada, they both lost their newborn baby. Gertrude was afraid to lose her husband, so before Mr. Banda went out of the country, she told Mr. Banda that she's pregnant again because she was afraid that Mr. Banda would leave her. That's when Gertrude made a plan and adopted her daughter. And Mr. Banda would believe this because he was out of the country over a year.
I have no more questions for you.
Thank you.
You see, your story doesn't quite add up. You were Mr. Banda's mistress at some point, am I right?
Objection, your lordship.
Objection overruled.
Answer my question.
What does my personal life have to do with this?
Or maybe you were so hurt and you wanted him to feel the pain by giving revenge? Huh? Or was it because he dumped you and went to his wife because she was pregnant? Isn't it?
Objection, my lord.
Objection overruled.
My lord, I have no more questions for this woman. My lord, may I call upon my witness, Mrs. Gertrude Banda, to the stand?
Please proceed.
Introduce yourself.
Mrs. Gertrude Banda.
Mrs. Gertrude Banda, can you tell the court what happened to Sam Banda on the 21st July 1989?
Lisa came to me and asked me to kill Sam Banda. I refused. She then said she was going to do it herself since I did not want to do it, and threatened to kill me if I told anyone. I was so scared. And for 28 years, I kept this from my husband. I then told Lisa that I was going to tell my husband because I could not hide it anymore.
My lord, I have no more questions.
Thank you. That's it. Prosecution.
It's no time for tears, Mrs. Gertrude Banda. Since you know how to speak the truth, I'll provide a DNA doctor 5 to 10 minutes. But I believe you save us time. Is Hendrina Banda your biological child?
No.
Is Hendrina Mr. Banda's biological daughter?
Objection, my lord. Out of context.
Objection overruled. Please proceed.
Let me ask that question again. Is Hendrina Banda Mr. Banda's biological daughter?
No.
I have no more questions for you. My lord, since she has denied killing Sam Banda, I would like to call my last witness, Atu Chawula.
Proceed.
Atu, could you please explain to this court what happened in 1989?
It was on the 21st of July that my son died. I went out for a walk in Ofulu Drive near my home, and I just looked away. For a few seconds, and I heard a loud noise of brakes squeaking. I turned to take my son off the road, but it was too late. I saw him lying on the ground, dead.
Would you recognize the face of the driver who hit your son?
Yes.
Is that face in this courtroom?
Yes.
Would you kindly point to that face?
Gertrude Banda.
Objection, my lord. This is not an investigation room.
Objection sustained.
Arthur, if you say that you can point the face in this room, why then did you sketch it for the police then?
I sketched the face, but it was my word against hers.
Her word against yours. My lord, if you see from the way she's answering, means that whatever she's saying is unreliable because she would have used it then. Why is she deciding to use it now?
Objection, my lord.
Objection sustained.
My lord, Lisa Mari and Gertrude Banda killed Sam Banda. I would like to give you my last piece of evidence. But before I do that, do you have anything else to say?
Not really, but there's one more thing I'd like to say. I'm so sorry, my daughter. I wish I had told you this earlier. The first day that I saw Gertrude Banda, the woman who killed my son, with my ex-husband, Mr. Banda, holding hands and pregnant, I was angry, confused, and frustrated. I promised myself that I was going to avenge the death of my son by giving her a taste of her own soup. I took her one and only hope and turned it into my own hope. I couldn't kill a child, so I took her daughter, whom up to now she still thinks died, and turned her into my own daughter. I raised her with so much love and care. She is and always will be my happiness, my hope. She gave me a reason to go on and a will to survive. And I love her so much.
What are you saying?
I'm sorry, my daughter, but Gertrude is your biological mother. I had to pay a doctor to fake your death so that I could take you.
I'm here to honor the agreement we made last time. Is it okay? Can I do it here?
I don't know what else to say. I'm sorry. Please forgive me.
Sam Banda, who died on 21st July 1989, I find Gertrude Banda and Lisa Sugar guilty with first degree murder, and I sentence both of you to 16 years imprisonment with hard labor. As the court was hearing the evidence, it came to the attention that there was a child who was stolen by the one who was tendering the evidence. And this court is of the view that this matter needs further investigations. So we shall ask the prosecution to proceed with new investigations to open this case. Case closed.
It's okay, Mom. It's going to be fine.
Thank you.
Thank
Go tenga sambileza, amabona.